So this is my newest DIY project. It's a set of monoblock power amplifiers. It's based off high pass 17 power amplifiers modules, and it's supposed to have about 200 watts into 4 ohms and about 110 into 8 ohms. I would like to explain you all the details and stuff, so you know how it works. So I've got one which is not really finished yet entirely, which needs to be sealed, and the other one is almost finished. I'll anchor it so you can see how it looks like. I bought enclosures from siliconray.com. It's a Chinese company and they're sending worldwide, and each enclosure cost me about $150, but then I let another company mill me a top and bottom piece and also do me a every panels, so it looks like that. It's quickpanel.sk. It's a Slovakian company, or Czech company, if you will. And also they did the inside tray. I have to say that this is my first serious DIY project, and I really over-engineer it. So I wouldn't do it that way again. But still haven't finished entirely yet. Even these piece, I've got badges here, which I have to polish. I've got polishing kit, and we'll polish it to high gloss finish, and cut it, and it should be insert it over here, so it will look really nice. So those enclosures I bought off Siliconray, but the feet I bought also from Custom Works, and they are absolutely lovely. They are one of the best looking feet I ever seen on the internet. I've got also more feet up here, which will be a little bit pain to show that now. This is my another project which I'm will be working on it later. It should be a headphone amplifier, and I've got those feeds here, so you will kind of see how it looks like. And there they are. They look like that. I really can't see, but they are super nice. I really recommend them. They are absolutely solid, and they are really for good price as well, and they made in Europe, so. Yeah, that's the thing. And alright, so I'll put that one back and explain you the rest. So I also, like a perfectionist, I wanted to have all the functions as high-end amplifiers have. So it does have a soft start, which is here, mate. By also Custom Works, can't really see, I suppose, but and then it's got a DC filter, also from Custom Works, and fairly quiet, I would say absolutely quiet, transformer from I think Czech company Telema. I got all delivered by Pavel from Custom Works, so. And this is the main star of the show, which is modules high pass 17. I've got actually a little bit of writing here. So Woody says it's got 190 into 4 ohms, but apparently it's got about 220, could give you. And it's JFET transistors. I think it's not really sure, I think they are Toshibas or something like that. And yeah, bipolar transistors, 400 watts. and I have to say I sit bias for 180 milliamps, and it's absolutely really cool. It just don't have any problems with cooling it, so I probably different situation will be if I rank it up a little bit and it will be loud. Now I've got this module is from OC Amplifiers. It's a speaker protection board, which I had to little bit update to actually accommodate these new modules. Well, why are you asking, probably, why is those amplifiers in the way they are? It looks a little bit funny, but it was because I first bought a amplifiers modules from OC Amplifiers, and they absolutely disappoint me with the sound quality, with micro details, and they are right into subwoofers and stuff, but otherwise they are really really disappointing sound wise. So I wouldn't definitely recommend them. They're using quite a lot of SMD parts, and they are really cramped, and the PCB is not perfect. It's just it was a big disappointment. I was looking for the best possible DIY modules I could possibly get in the world, like high-end, and this is the best solid state I think in the world you can get in class AB. And I would say in class D there are some decent those Hypex modules in class D, they are really nice as well. But I think these ones beat them. So what I have here, it's just I'll take a light so you can see a little bit better. So in there, it's just right. So I've got all the nice writing there. All the nice writing. And it's got one input RCA, and it's got double binding post, speaker binding post, and it's got 12 volt trigger in and out, so it could work in slave or master mode, which I wanted. So that's what I wanted. That's why I pay extra for this feature, because I'm quite lazy, and I basically wanted a high quality product, and didn't want I could buy like £11 soft starts and stuff, but they just doesn't have any protections, and like thermal protection soft start button. I used buttons from what are they called, from Shooter, I don't know how it's supposed to pronunciation. They are really nice. They are really expensive, but they are really nice. I used binding posts from Customwares. They are kind of WBT copies, and I obviously use Neotrik connectors with Shooter IEC connector. So inside, if I have a look from that side, you can see there's a heatsink. It was all designed for the RC amplifier, so I have to just adjust it a little bit. Alright, so it's got double wiring, 35 volts AC, and what should I say, what else? Those soft starts, if you have a look, probably can't see it from here, but it's got a button with LED, which I'll explain later. It's got a thermostat, which is wired here, and it's got which I customized a little bit with support of Customworks LED, which is on right now, and I'll explain you those functions later as well. And it's got double output, which you can't see again, double output with double fuse inside. It's because it's orange in it and it's like in this kind of tray. It's a little bit pain in the ass, and it's quite hard to access, so I just make sure that everything's fine and working. It's a little bit, I would do it totally differently this time, and it would cost me much less to make and everything, you know. It's that RC connectors going there into the port, and I made sure that it's got the shortest signal path possible. You can see from top how it looks like that, and I just polish it really to make it look really nice. I have actually here a little bit of information from the manufacturer, so we've got some information here. We've got 200 watts into 4 ohm, 430 into 8 ohm, and then these got absolutely really low distortion. Those, it's got measurements here, and it's got absolutely super low distortion. And I have to say, I've got a little review here to tell you about. Oh god. Because I've got also a tube amplifier, Macintosh MT75, which is about, I don't know, £4,500, depends on tubes. Amplifier, which is, I would say, quite expensive. And I've got it connected to balanced XLRs, and I've got Tannoy Sterling speakers, and so with SD200, I've got a super tweeters, which is another £4,500, so I can kind of compare fairly high. So the main differences between those, that little review between Macintosh MC275, which fifth generation, and these hyper solid state amps, is that the hyper is, compared to Macintosh, is coming from much greater depth, but more precisely, and kind of like from one further distanced source. And with some certain music, hyper is creating effect that you can hear actually instruments coming from behind your chair. I have soundproofing and diffusers, so I've got fairly good acoustics in my room. It's fairly flat, and it gives you really goosebumps. That's really a great 3D effect. But on the other side, right, tube amp will fill up room with music a little bit more, but location of instruments is not as clear. And tube also is like a warmer sound, so those who prefer warmer sound for folk and vocals probably prefer that. But I would say amount of micro details is pretty much the same. And the tube amp is adding a bit more reverb, but where these solid states absolutely excel, which is like, I don't know, €500 modules, you can build it for, with enclosures, with YouTube, some cheap enclosures and everything, you can build it in for, I don't know, you don't want to lie, £800 maybe, £700. But these will beat your £5,000 amplifier with ease, I bet, because I was really surprised how good they are for DIY. Because they where they excel is that with chamber music, big orchestras, drumming sessions, or generally the music, I have to say, they're absolutely beating anything we could compare it to. We compare it to Primar, some monoblocks, they've been absolutely beaten by these, and we compare it to a Belcanto Class D, which was really nice, but it was lacking detail compared to these. So I have to say these are superior to the others, and I'm not lying now. I don't have really reasons to say anything like that. So it's really, really fast bass, really nice sound. Right, but I don't say that tubes are better or this is better. It's really up to people's like choice and on tastes. So that's kind of like review now. And what I have to say that I'll show you the functions kind of. So you can hear if I go show you here. I turn it off. All right. So I'm gonna show you. Not gonna show you the other one as well. I'll show you on this one. It's got three LEDs. It's got orange, which means standby mode. A green one, which is connected to with the button, which is kind of this one. And that orange LED, which is standby, is connected to PCB. It's all that on it, so that's not like a standard feature. And then it's got a red LED, which is speaker protection board. So you know that there's some DC voltage, or it's just switched on at the beginning anyway, before the relay was set. And those modules got good DC protection, I think, short circuit protections as well, so they are really user friendly. Anyway, I'll show you now how it works then. So if I turn it on with the sure, so you see, I hope you can see that it's actually orange. So it's orange. Now, if I turn it on, there's a green and red, and then the other one switch on as well. And if I push the button, they both switch off. Bang. So that's the thing. And that's kind of it. Yeah, it's got 300 watts double winding, triple winding transformer, and all those things I actually explained already. So if I did it, I wanted to. The main thing was to make sure that there's nice airflow. So what I did, it's got actually, if I turn it on, you will see that it's actually got some, or you can see it on there, right on, all like that. It's got some LEDs inside. If I turn the light out, you can kind of see from here, and so you can see those LEDs here, but they just light up when you start setting up bias. They just light up, and it's just didn't really have a look for it. So what it means, those lights there. So yeah, there's like a flow of air which is coming from the bottom. If you have a look from the bottom here, and then through those heat sinks to the top here. So yeah, and what I wanted to make sure, I'm gonna switch it off now. What I wanted to make sure that they look really neat. So I think they look absolutely amazing. The enclosure is really cheap, so I urge anyone to have a look on that silicone ray, because you probably all people fed up with module shop. And now I show you kinda how it looks like from the side. I hope it's not gonna fall down. So there you go. From the bottom side, oh shit! From the bottom side, they look like that. As again, I just really, really wanted to make them look really neat. I'm gonna put it down. Ah. you don't want any accidents here. So yeah, thank you for watching, and start your DIY project as well. And this time I'll show you what else I've got for DIY projects. So they're gonna be absolutely amazing, they're gonna sound amazing. And it took me about a year to make them, you know, slowly. Because it took two months to make those custom-made CNC milled pieces. Then that OC amplifier, which was absolute disappointment. Then waiting for hyper modules and all those things. Then obviously I was a little bit lazy over the summertime. And yeah, it was all worth it in the end, I have to say. And this is the last part, so I'm kind of completing those amps, and just want to show you that the cable for connecting of soft start, that trigger, which is XLR for a new trick. And I just wanted to make it a little bit more durable and a little bit more high-endish, but that's just bullshit, because those mini jacks or jacks, mono jacks are as good as these, so I don't do that. And the last thing, I got those bars here, which is those pieces of aluminium top. This is the side, and it looks like that. And then I've got the top piece, which is here. Just gonna show you what it looks like. Put it on windowsill, so it's not really safe here. But it looks like that. Yeah, it's been milled. This is one side, and this is outside. It's eloxed aluminium for sanded, so it looks really nice. Yeah, and and now I complete it. I used so many little screws here. This is M4 screw. And I used screws here, always got screws everywhere. It's got all together maybe more than 100 of screws, Allen keys.